If my A1C is telling me I'm diabetic and my CGM is telling me I'm fine, which one do I trust? This is a clip from a live Q&A session open to CMJ Masterpass members. In addition to this episode, you can access lots of other free samples from these sessions at the first link in the description.
Hemoglobin, A1C. So I'm playing with continuously glucose monitor since like 17 months. And my glucose is around, the average glucose is under 100. It could be 90 for three months. And then I try to figure something out. I can go up to 95, 97. If I'm spiking, maybe 152, but for only 5 minutes or 10, let's say 10 maximum, and then goes back right how it's supposed to be. But my hemoglobin A1C, it's always coming back high. So between 5.5 and 5.6 every time.
The continuous glucose monitor trumps the HbA1c hands down and makes it irrelevant, because the point of HbA1c is that it is a useful but imperfect marker of cumulative past glucose exposure, and you are actually completely tracking all of your glucose exposure. And so it's sort of like completely pointless to measure HbA1c if you have a continuous glucose monitor, because you're using something that is an imperfect marker to try to make an inference about something where you have the exact data of. It's sort of like calculated LDL cholesterol and exact LDL cholesterol. If you had them measured in the same test and the calculated one looked bad and the exact one looked good, you would ignore the calculated one because the calculation isn't perfect and obviously it's wrong. But the reason is that HbA1c is subject to two other determinants besides cumulative past glucose exposure. One is red blood cell turnover. Things that we know can increase your red blood cell turnover include exercise, include any kind of blood loss, right? So like if you have a heavier period, or you're running like a lot of lab tests, or you donate blood, all of these things can increase your red blood cell turnover. And so that, and then there's also just other determinants of red blood cell turnover that are unknown. So probably for genetic reasons or hormonal reasons or whatever it is, some people just have higher red blood cell turnover than other people, and it's a confounder. Then the second thing is that you actually have an enzyme called fructosamine 3 kinase that deglycates hemoglobin. And there are some things that might impact that, but there's also a strong genetic component. And I don't know if you can like get that measured with a test, but in research, they can test it. And there's a very significant inverse correlation between fructosamine 3 kinase activity and HbA1c, where HbA1c goes down if that enzyme is high, and if that enzyme is low, HbA1c goes up. So you're taking this HbA1c measurement, which in you is a little bit high. And there are three possible interpretations. One is that your cumulative cumulative blood glucose exposure over the last 4 to 8 weeks is high, in the pre-diabetic range. Another is that your red blood cell turnover is a little bit lower than average. And a third is that your fructosamine 3 kinase activity is a little bit lower than average. And you've ruled out the first one because your continuous monitor shows that that's not true. And therefore, you know it's one or two of these other confounding factors that makes HbA1c borderline useless in some cases, such as yours.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for your question. Appreciate it. This is a clip from a live Q&A session open to CMJ Masterpass members. In addition to this episode, you can access lots of other free samples from these sessions at the first link in the description. If you want to become a Masterpass member so that you can participate in the next live Q&A, or so that you can have access to the complete recording and transcript of each Q&A session, you can join at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass. you can save 10% off the subscription price for as long as you remain a member by signing up at chrismasterjohnphd.substack.com/Q&A. That's Q&A spelled out as Q-A-N-D-A. These links are in the description.